Hello and welcome back to FTCR. Here is a mystery video. Oh, it's spoiled already.
Uh-huh.
That's okay. Fine, because it would have been spoiled anyway at this point. Hey.
I immediately feel the need to give context. For months, David is like, oh man, I want to record a secret thing and show it to you guys and we can talk over it. And I was like, yeah, what a good idea.
Uh-huh.
And we finally get to the night. We're about to record Sonic Frontiers. And yeah. David's like, oh, I got the mystery video. And I was like, great. I've been so curious. I did not expect this.
Right. This is a Barbie Supermodel. Right. Okay. So we've got Smoovies.
Oh, wow.
We've got...
oh yes,
Stefan movies. We've got Steven movies, Stefan movies, and Chris movies, and me. I'm not a movie. I'm a limited edition miniseries. This is Barbie Supermodel. This is a game that I played way too much as a child because I had a sister who was really into Barbie, and because I was obsessed with the Sega Genesis, she was obsessed with Barbies. This was something that crisscrossed our interests. This is a good game.
A true chocolate and peanut butter moment, if there ever was one.
That's right. See, you're is Barbie. This,
What is this game?
I don't think you want to pick up that magazine on the ground.
Right. Well,
you don't know where it's been.
You don't know where it's been and who's had it, Barbie.
Oh, wait, so David, did you choose hard mode at the beginning?
Yeah.
Like you chose supermodel mode,
yes.
Right?
There's three modes. Okay. There's supermodel, junior model.
So you're hardcore.
And free play.
If you don't play on hard, you don't get the actual final boss.
Right, right. Well, yeah, there is an ending that's only in supermodel if you do it good enough. I guess I should have looked into like, oh, is it a point value? But I didn't bother that much. In fact, I was going to look up every Barbie doll from this era and tell you exactly what's what, but I also completely forgot to do that.
Okay.
That's okay. So, okay. I wouldn't be interested in
it. I was gonna say she's going really slow, but considering how much slower the other cars are going, she's actually speeding.
Yeah. See,
she's also not stopping at the lights.
Barbie, no.
No. No. And she's also driving between the lines. Right. So
Barbie the kind of girl to go 15 on a 10 mile per hour, I swear to God.
All right. There she is. She's practicing.
Where's the beep button, Matt? Oh.
So how hard
right,
is
see,
this?
I'm pressing B here to show you what the dance is. How hard is this? So he's a...
Yeah. You're on supermodel mode. How hard is this? Is it hard?
No. This game is not
was it a timing thing? What happened?
Okay, so the idea of this game is that you go from left to right, then you go to the practice room where you have to memorize those four button presses, because then when you go right to left, you actually do it. You do the modeling. As you can see, I got hit there. And then also
at the place she's going to model.
Right. Well, she's practicing her moves because Barbie is a supermodel, according to this game.
God, this reminds me of Bart's nightmare. Running around the street, right. Jumping into an item.
Right. So when you hit the item, so the first one was, oh, Barbie's, this is her magazine. You got to remember what it looks like. And here, it's like, this is her close-up. You got to remember what it looks like and then match it. So this game is really... It's about memorizing because, you got to remember what she looked like, but you also got to remember what the buttons were from the other side because you won't get maximum points. See, look, it says Barbie. It's how you know it's Barbie.
This seems unfun.
Well, this part's almost... Right. This part's almost like a game, right? Because you're driving in a car. Oh, I couldn't get it. This is not 100% playthrough. I missed that star.
Oh, David.
Yeah.
You could have given us a 100% run of Barbie. Who's a what's it?
Oh! Barbie Supermodel. See?
Yeah.
And when you hear the chime, that means it's right. Whoa! And then... Whoa! Oh! She did it!
She walked into the wall!
She did. She's unconscious. I remember this Barbie. That's Hollywood Barbie. Oh. Or is it Hollywood Hair? Wait, or is Hollywood Hair the long... No. I think it's... It doesn't matter.
Was she just on the beach, imagining being on the beach?
Yeah, I think the framing device is her writing in her diary, like, "Dear diary, today I went to the beach.
Oh.
There were birds who tried to murder me, and this ball almost caused me brain damage."
Sam isn't conducive right. to roller skating, as it turns out.
No.
Chris, when I go to different countries, I imagine being in a different place entirely, not the place I'm in.
I guess that's fair.
I'm really hoping that the Greta Gerwig movie copies a lot from this.
See, okay, did you memorize that? I hope you did.
No.
No. Oh, well.
I lose.
You'll let me know, right? Is that it? I'm playing it live. Not.
Is it this one?
It was this one.
Is it this one? Is it this
one? I think it's this one. Dun, 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 dun. Right. Yeah, my sister had a lot of Barbies. She had a whole tub full of them. And I would play Barbie with her. Of course, it was never just straight up, "Oh, I'm a girl and I like fashion." I introduced some weird things.
Do you want to reword that?
No, this David's is fine.
Well, we're just living in it.
Right. Well, because we had this whole universe that was mostly Barbies. I do remember because she had 30 Barbies and 4 Kens, the Barbies would yell at each other about who would get the boy because he had a very rudimentary understanding
There's
of how relationships
the bees.
Work.
There they are.
Right. There's some bees. And then,
now you can shut
and then this is A.
The
See, the
Thank
A is
you,
twirl, and there's no A. Yeah. But also, I was like, man, what if things get interesting? So every once in a while, I would say, "Oh no, there's a lava storm." And I would force all the Barbies to stand on the roof of the Barbie house and watch as lava just strolls on by. It never caused any issues. What?
So you introduced situations as like going on top of the roof and waiting.
Yeah. Sis, I got a great idea. This is so much more fun. What if they all had to stay on the roof? Now I'm gonna go eat a snack. You stay here, there's a lot of lava.
This is what the two kids from the Lego movie ended up turning into.
Yeah. Well, because there was also, we had this giant stuffed rabbit, which was like as tall as us when we were small children. And that rabbit came from a Hallmark store. We won it. And by won it, I mean, my mother knew somebody who worked there and she rigged the contest so we would win it. And then that giant bunny, because if you search like Hallmark Easter rabbit, it'll come up on the internet, on the YouTube.
Sure.
And
let's see.
Or oh yeah. There. Has it been put into the video? I don't know. But when you do that, or when that rabbit became the wise old Bunimon, is what we called it, and it was like a mystical figure that like knew the future and would tell the Barbies that they had destinies and stuff. And there was also, that is not the rabbit.
Thank God. Because holy shit, look at that rabbit.
Right.
His face. He's got a Joker smirk.
Yeah, that is the wrong rabbit. Oh, geez.
There's a lot of rabbits that research Hallmark Easter rabbit. I just want to say.
Oh, okay. Well, here, maybe I can just find it real fast. Hallmark Easter bunny. It was from the early 90s. Oh, here. I found a picture of somebody dressed as the rabbit.
Great.
In holding a small child.
That's...
We've already lost interest in talking about the game.
No, I love this game.
So, like, what'd you guys do last week? Oh, Pinterest. Oh my god, that's worse.
David, which game did you play with your sister last week?
Last week I didn't play any. We're actually recording this on my sister's birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Hey.
Happy birthday, Sister the Lurker.
Woo!
I don't think she's ever watched any of these videos.
Sister the Lurker.
I can't imagine, why not?
What about David the Sister?
Oh, look, she's in snow clothing.
No, okay, that's so, 90s.
That does look very 90s, doesn't it? I like it. Well, I thought I'll share, like, this is a game that nobody talks about because it's not much of a game, but it is something that is near and dear to my heart, because when you're a child and you only have a handful of video games, you play what you got. And this is, I think, still the only Genesis game my sister ever owned.
Right.
So.
Yeah. I mean, I honestly, you say that, but it's like, yeah, I have a bunch of PS1 and licensed PS1 and PS2 and Wii games that I played all the time when I was like 10, less than 10. I played with my younger siblings, and it's like, yeah, they're cringe. A lot of them are very cringy and stuff like that, but it's like, yeah, I have so many memories about them.
Mm-hmm. I think my equivalent might be Power Rangers Lightspeed Rescue for the N64, which was of a similar quality to this.
I mean, I would defend it saying it's much better, but like, say, the Blue's Clues game on PS1, I played all the time, and that was like something of being like, yes, like I would get into that so hard.
David, is it possible to get the combination ACAB?
it is. I think it is. Actually, oh God. What is the last one? We'll get back to it.
I have an idea for a ROM pack, suddenly. You know,
hey, do I see something else disturbing? Here's what the Genesis cartridge looks like.
No! Okay.
I don't like it.
It has a seal of quality, though.
It's a Barbie doll.
No, but like, usually on most Barbie games, like, the Barbie is like animated Barbie, and like, but this is like the only Barbie game I've ever seen where it's literally just the doll, and it doesn't look good. This is why they don't do that.
I feel like a lot of YouTube channels that go for low hanging Barbie game fruit, go for the NES game, right? Because you're like, oh, Barbie, she's jumping and there's the bat and she's sleeping and it's funny. But this is a 16-bit game, so it's better, right?
Yes. Sight unseen for that other one. Absolutely.
Right. Well, I remember it because it was the first video the game dude ever recorded.
I've heard tale from you about the game dude.
Ah, yes, the game dude. He.
God bless his soul.
Right, because he just starts. Yeah. Yeah. He's. Is he still on the run? I forget. Well, he ran away to Mexico. And then he...
Because he was so rude.
What? Well, no, because he started stalking his ex-girlfriend.
Oh!
but also, I'm pretty sure AVG... That sounds rude. I'm also pretty sure AVGN did a video on Barbie.
Yes, AVGN's making of video, where he was like, I'm going to show you how I make an AVGN episode.
Oh, that's right! Yeah, that's right. Barbie. Okay, now I remember.
Right.
Yeah.
And it was like, oh, I wonder if he did that because of the game. Barbie's dressed warm. I don't know why Stefan, the practice room is far away from this room. She did it.
Don't worry about it.
That one woman isn't even looking at Barbie. She was like looking away, looking at the camera.
I'm just trying to...
Oh, there's the Twin Towers!
Barbie, no!
No!
I'm just trying to process that we are, like, 14 minutes in, and we've kind of already seen this entire game, if you think about it. Like, this is kind of just a rollerblading thing, but on a bike. She dances.
It's all the same.
Yeah,
But you gotta avoid things like that bird.
Oh.
Look, I avoided the bird. You can... If you press one button, you go faster. If you press another button, you go slower.
Okay.
And then you want to avoid everything except that, because that gives you this. And then you have to match Barbie with the magazine cover. And you have to go back to this, yes. So there she is.
Uh-huh.
Oh. And you change that. And then you change the necklace, and then you change the shoes. And
does...
I didn't even notice the necklace change.
Yeah, well...
Oh, my God.
Oh, but it. did it. You get 100 bonus if you mash them all three elements. And that's what I've done.
I suspect we'll get our answer, but does this just go indefinitely until you fail? Or is there an actual specific end? Like an amount of times you go through this and then the game says that's enough.
Yeah, there's an ending. There's a difference. There's the supermodel ending.
Oh, right.
I didn't record the junior model ending.
Oh, David.
I know, I really should have. It's okay, though. There she goes!
Oh. Bye, Barbie. back to the practice room.
We're back in the practice room. They're all the same. Like, presumably she's going across the country, but she always finds this one room. This is BCBA. Which is almost...
It's getting there.
It's almost... It's close, but it's not exact.
She's building up the courage.
That's why I was like, wait, did it? But no. I assume it's random. I forget. Oh, I'm just messing up for some reason.
All copies of Barbie Supermodel are personalized.
Whew, gotta get back to the modeling stage, sweaty from my bike.
Yeah.
Move out of the way.
She's a famous supermodel. You know, there's a lot of Barbie lore. I do find Barbie lore interesting. You know, because she's had multiple siblings over the years. Some of them are no longer canon.
Oh.
Yeah, like she used to have a brother. Brother's not a brother anymore.
Oh, good for them.
Oh no, that could be. Oh, okay. No, you did the good answer. Okay, all right, okay.
Right, that it's been he's been decanonized because it's like Barbie. What it was is Kelly, who is like the toddler, 5-year-old, whatever. Like she used to have a different name that escapes me, and she was a twin, and she had a twin brother. But then when they re-released her, they renamed her Kelly and got rid of the brother. So she was just, she's just Barbie's other younger sister because it's Skipper and Stacy and Kelly. And then occasionally there's like a baby, like a little baby. But that baby sometimes isn't canon either. It depends on what Mattel is feeling at the time.
Oh.
Yeah.
Barbie's life is as plastic as her body.
She is a rich tapestry of Barbie-ness. There was a website that I used to go to that talked about all the different versions of Ken, because it was like, wow, he's had like 8 different head molds and here's how you know the differences. And it's like, yeah, this could be interesting.
You haven't decided yet? You watched it all and you're like, he could be.
Could be. Oh, look, they're taking photos.
I have to say,
because she's a supermodel.
Sega Retro page on this game is a little lacking. I was trying to...
Here's the ending.
Oh, whoa. Oh, it's...
And there's Ken.
Oh, this is the supermodel ending.
This is the supermodel ending. You did it.
I was trying to figure out how much this game cost, because, man. Huh.
And there's the Sega logo.
Oh my god,
again.
Those are the credits. They were just names, but there were no titles.
Tahoe.
Well, that was... Yeah. Oh. If you'll notice, there's still more to this video.
Oh, there is.
Mm-hmm.
New Game Plus.
Because...
New Game Plus.
You gotta know what free play is.
Oh.
This is free play.
Alright.
So far, so good. You can just do this. Yes. you can mix and match. She's beautiful.
What are the buttons? Because I can't see what you're pressing. What are you doing to change the outfit?
I am pressing A and B and C.
What? Does A cycle through the shirt? Does B cycle
buttons.
Through the pants?
You just listed all the buttons.
Right. Well, you use the D-pad. You use the D-pad to go... To push her in behind the hiding thing so you can never see Barbie in her plasticness.
To push her soft spot in.
Right. And so then when she slides out, yeah. So
head.
You have A, B, and C. And that's like A is the because the first thing is A, what I'm pushing. So that's the shirt. B is the pants.
Okay.
And then C are the shoes. And then you can just be like, well, yeah, cool.
Earlier you were changing like a necklace. So like, is it because she was wearing a dress that the necklace became like a third option?
Yes.
Because there are no pants.
Right. So the dress is one, and then the necklace is two, and then the shoes are three. Right. Okay. And so,
but in this, yeah,
this you just get to see everything.
Everything?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh. I'm going to push the button to shove her up behind the wall, like you said.
See, that's a good texture for her top. It's not busy.
Yeah.
It's not painful to the eyes.
Probably looks better on a CRT.
I'm sure it does. But you see, my sister owns it. I don't, so I can't use my original Sega Genesis to play this. And...
Or just eBay a copy, David.
But next time, I could re-record it and just point a camera at the TV as well.
That would make this so unsettling. Oh, no.
Hey, guys, here's my Barbie Supermodel Let's Play. I pointed the camera at my CRT. I can change her outfits and push her behind the wall.
How much longer can this go on?
Well, there's a lot. Like, we're still in winter. Right. Well, because you don't get to see all the options when you're choosing. I mean, you could, but I didn't. Instead, I went, I'll wait for free play.
So when you push her behind the screen, like a random outfit comes out?
It's all the same order.
Okay.
So at some point, it's like, well, this is the last outfit. And then you will be granted the sweet release of this mode.
Oh, there's an...
Da-da.
She changes really fast. There's,
she's a, right. Well, because you know, when you are a supermodel, you have to learn how to dress and undress quickly, because you're always going on the runway
and slide without moving your feet.
Did you try the Game Genie code for unlimited tries?
I did
unlimited
not.
Clothes.
I didn't know there was. Is there an unlimited? That's exciting to me.
What other crazy scenarios did you get your sister's Barbies into?
I feel like there were definitely like political situations. There was a Barbie who sort of became like the main Barbie, right? And so the main Barbie was actually the gymnast one who could, well, no, she was dressed all in pink and she could actually bend her limbs, which was unique at the time. And so then there was a secondary Barbie who was very upset. She could also bend her limbs, but she wasn't in charge of the Barbies. And she also then didn't get the Ken. And she was like, I want to steal her Ken and make him mine. And I want to be in charge of the Barbies. There was also Belle and Beast. You know, they were incorporated into the storyline. We called Beast, when he took off the Beast part. Oh, here's all her heads. And he's like, oh, I'm
B
the prince.
B&B, Belle and Beast. We called him. She has fond memories of them.
Right. Yes.
Uh-huh. So if you're writing the syndicated TV show for Barbie, do you like occasionally have the camera zoom in on their elbows and knees bending to help sell the toys?
Maybe. Right. So the Beast, he became known as Squishface because his face was so, like, squishy, like, you could bend it to the side and his head wouldn't pop off, it'd just be, like, really long and flat. And we thought it was very funny. And so then we also made him a complete idiot. I guess maybe, like, right, because he was, like, completely dumb. And he ended up dating this dollar store Barbie knockoff who kind of looked like Mary Tyler Moore. And so Belle was upset and she ended up dating a dollar store army man who was also kind
not a
of
dollar store army man.
He would always fall up. He would break in half, right? Like he would always fall apart. So his legs would be separate from his torso. And right, but so there was, you know, there was some political intrigue. There was some romance and some breaking up.
Some mystery.
There was some mystery and lava storms and a giant rabbit. And it was a good time. And it's over.
Well, I'd say that therapy session went as well as it could have. David, you can come back into our office same time next week and we'll explore some of this more together. Don't forget to talk to your receptionist on the way out. Copay is pretty high.
Okay.